My guest this week is Republican State Representative Pam Tucker of Greenland. Tucker is the co-chair of the Conservative House Republican Alliance. Thank you so much for coming in.
Sure, thank you for having
me. Well, we saw this week Governor Maggie Hassan giving her inauguration, getting sworn in. What are we expecting to see from Republicans, particularly in the House?
Well, since we are now in the minority party, we're still a presence in there. We're not a very small minority. And what you will see is probably more of the conscience of the House come out now. And that's more or less what the minority party does. The majority party is going to be the ones who are pushing the policy and pushing the agenda through. However, we're the ones that when they're pushing bad policy through, we're the ones who are going to stand up and tell the voters why it is bad policy. And we will continue to do that.
Obviously, we saw a disagreement this week in the House over guns in the State House or in around the House chamber. And what we saw is our Republicans, like yourself, putting up another number of amendments, slowing down the process a bit. Is that what we're going to expect to see, I think, this session, is a number of holding their feet to the fire, but also, you know, kind of putting up some long jams.
Well, when you see bad legislation coming down or bad rules such as this was by many members of the House, as witnessed by the number of people who got up there and spoke, we will make a point of raising why this is not a good thing to do. And in the case of the gun legislation, many, many representatives took it personally and needed to get up and make themselves be heard.
Is there one thing where you can say, you know what, we need to accomplish it this year and we know that we can get Democratic support to accomplish something big?
Oh, in terms of our legislative agenda?
Yeah.
Is the agenda
to stop things that are bad, or is the agenda actually, is there one or two pieces of item of works that you want to do to get things done?
Well, we'd like to work with them on the budget. Mm-hmm. And we saw in the past 2 years very responsible budgeting. If you look at the numbers that have come in terms of the revenues, they're actually very close to the actuals. We hope we'll do that again with the help of the ruling party. And when we put together the actual budget, it will be based on those reasonable revenue figures.
Great. Thanks so much for coming in. Now you can read more about state-level politics at WMUR.com/political scoop. That's also where you can find an extended version of this interview. But that does it here for TV. Now back to you.
Am I done?
We have a few more minutes here extra online. I want to talk to you a little bit more about the politics of the Republican Party, particularly in the New Hampshire House. You know, we saw on this particular gunfight, if you will, that there are just, you know, a handful of folks who are very powerful, very passionate about the issue, but leadership wasn't exactly backing you up. What was going on there?
Leadership knew what we were doing. Representative Chandler and his group did know everything that was going on the House floor. We had consulted with them. Mm-hmm. But he saw that there was a big group of people, and they came from all different backgrounds. This wasn't just the House Republican Alliance. This was people from everywhere who felt very strongly on this issue. And if you listen to some of the debate up there, you had people for personal things that had happened to them, from being in a shootout situation to preventing someone, a deterrent in their own home.
Mm-hmm. Let me ask you also, broadly speaking, New Hampshire Republican politics. We have a chairman's race coming up. What do you think is going to happen in some of those dynamics? Who's going to win? What are we going to watch for?
I've been so focused on the House at this time, I have stayed totally away from the state politics.
Yeah, fair enough. And so when it comes back to the state House, what do you think is sort of the driving factor, particularly in the House? Is it just Terry Norelli? Do you think there's going to be a bit of a mix between Republican and Democrat?
The driving force this time, I think, may be the governor. Mm. We have a new governor. This new governor is going to set the tone and the agenda for what happens in the Capitol building, not just in the House. And from that, of course, Speaker Norelli will be working very closely with her on that. And that's going to set the tone as to how we're going to work with the Democrats in the future.
What did you make of the governor's speech? What kind of governor will she be?
Personally?
Yeah.
Don't put that on tape. Please cut this out.
We're still on the air, but go ahead. No, I mean, Governor Hassan does appear that she will be more aggressive, right, in terms of a governor than John Lynch, who waited for things to come onto his desk.
I hope that Governor Hassan will work with everyone and listen to everyone in terms of hearing both sides of the issue and work for the people of the state and not for a political party.
Mm-hmm. Great. Thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching WMUR.com.